everybody, welcome to Magdeburg, Germany. I'm here with a good friend, Anthony Fischer, who is a church planter. And this city is about 240,000 people. I'm learning a lot about it. I came here first before I went to Wittenberg because Luther was here and my friend Anthony is here. And Anthony, tell me a little bit about church planting in this city, which you have said in our conversation yesterday is a really atheistic city.
Yes, Kevin, this is one of the most atheistic places in the world. East Germany, we have 86% of the people here in this town don't believe in God, have never prayed, many don't even have a concept or idea of what God is. And the challenge is that I think we Christians often assume they must have this longing for God, but people don't feel that yet. They're satisfied with their life, they don't sense any need for God, so the challenge is to show them that the gospel has something to give them. Hey Kevin, look who's here!
What? Rudolph?
Yeah.
Please tell me, Anthony, what did Martin Luther do here in Magdeburg?
I think for us, we know what happened through the Reformation, how it changed the world. But when Luther came here, the Reformation wasn't a thing. I mean, it was just a seed, and there was no idea of what would transpire. And he came here and he preached in one of the churches here. And this city was one of the first cities to adopt the Reformation. Many priests and preachers adopted the gospel, became reformed, and the whole city backed the Reformation, which was very important when religion and politics were mixed and it needed some backing for it to move ahead. So this was a crucial moment in Reformation history that Luther came here and the city said yes.
And Tony is going to explain in German what the phrase is and why is that important.
So it says, Gottes Wort mit uns in Ewigkeit, which means God's word with us for eternity. And this place is a historic place where Martin Luther preached in 1524, and the town accepted the Reformation, and this was a spiritually vital, alive place. Hundreds of years later, almost nothing is left from the Reformation apart from a cultural heritage. But this verse says that God's word is eternal and it stands firm in eternity, and that is the hope for this city and for all of the world, that God's word is powerful and never changes through time.
Hey everybody, I'm standing by this Magdeburg cathedral. It is ginormous. Tell my people how many people go into this monstrosity on a Sunday morning.
My guess is roughly, I've been there, 40 people, of which quite a few will be tourists or guests.
40 people inside this ginormous thing. It's so sad, and I don't know if this is religious-based or relationship-based. What do you think?
Both. There are some genuine believers, but there are some who are just religious.
Yeah, and it's sort of heartbreaking.
The Hubbrücke, a really old bridge that has been refurbished for Magdeburg, and people have put their messages here, and I love one of these because someone has put 1 Corinthians 13:13 here. Glaube, Hoffnung, Liebe, diese drei. It's faith, hope, and love, these three. And that's such an encouragement. It's what the city needs.
Okay, Anthony, in terms of prayer, how can I and my partners back in the States be praying for you in church planting here in Magdeburg?
I really appreciate the question, Kevin, because we are deeply aware of our need for prayer. Nothing less than God's miraculous working is going to change this place. And right now we are looking for people to join the team, other committed Christians with a missional lifestyle, a heart for the people here, maybe a family, maybe people working here to move here, join us as a team and be committed long term. And then we just really need divine encounters, that God would lead us to people whom he has prepared who are open for the gospel, and a lot of patience to walk them in minute steps all the way from not believing in God to following Jesus.